Hey everyone, in this tutorial I'm going to introduce some basic render settings in Character Creator 4 to export images in JPEG and PNG format, as well as videos in MP4 and image sequences. Let's look at how to render a basic JPEG first. You can access the render tool from either the top menu, which contains a few further options, or also from the top toolbar, which will take you directly into the render pop-up. You can click and drag the render window to dock it with the other tabs you have open in order to organize your workspace a bit more. In the format section at the top, we'll choose image in this case, and then ensure that JPEG is selected from the format dropdown. We'll render the current frame in this case, and ensure we max out the quality. In the output size section, there are a number of different presets in the frame size dropdown menu, and you can also manually enter the output size as well. You'll see the viewport change once I select 1080p to accommodate the newly defined dimensions. From there, you can use the lock ratio option, which will maintain that dimension ratio when you change the first x-axis number. In the render quality section, you'll generally want to make sure final render is selected, unless you're concerned about long render times. It is recommended to use high 3x3 anti-aliasing to ensure the highest quality. Anti-aliasing helps to smooth jagged edges that may appear in your render. There isn't any depth of field effect applied in this particular image, but if you have a DOF effect applied to your camera, you'll want to check that box. Finally, before rendering, you'll also want to ensure that you have your shader settings set to high in the drop-down menu on the toolbar. You can then proceed to click Export at the bottom and then enter your file name. Okay, let's look at how we can render a PNG, which contains alpha information and allows for transparent background. First, you'll want to select PNG from the render settings window, but if you want a transparent background, you'll need to go to the project settings in the edit menu. At the bottom, you'll see a checkbox for active image, which you'll want to uncheck. From there, you'll again want to max out the anti-aliasing, and if you still have any glow or lens flare effects, you can enable them as well. Make sure your shader settings are set high again, and then go ahead and export. After that, you'll have a completely transparent PNG render. Okay, next let's take a look at how to render a video. Start by clicking the video radio button in the format section, and in this case we're going to export to MP4. In the quality compressor, make sure that both video and audio are set to the highest quality. For frame rate, 30 is the standard for most uses, but you can also pump it up to 60 for smoother results. You have a lot of render options here, but for this simple tutorial, we're going to use the standard 1080p. Again, I'll max out the anti-alias settings for best results, and then I can move on to define the frame range for the final render. Again, for best results, always ensure that your shader settings are set to high. From there, just repeat the process by clicking on Export and defining your file name. Okay, lastly, let's look at exporting an image sequence. The main difference here is simply checking the sequence radio button in the format section. Generally, when you have an image sequence, it's good practice to put all of the images in a predefined folder, so make sure you create one. Once you do and proceed with the render, you'll find that the folder you defined will be filled with a number of images corresponding to the number of frames you rendered. Defining a higher frame rate will produce a larger number of images. That's really all the basics you need to know for rendering your project in Character Creator 4. For more in-depth tutorials, please remember to check out our Reillusion courses page. Thanks for watching, everyone, and I'll see you in the next video.